Oh, that light's so good. Look at the light up there now. Morning everybody, fantastic to see you all again. So I am in the Lake District before lockdown to try and get some of the amazing mist and a little bit of frost that it seems like was predicted this morning. However, it was a little bit windy, I heard it in the night, so I don't think we're going to get any mist, but it's worth a go anyway. I'm just a bit late here, so I'm just packing my lenses. I'm going to take a wide angle lens, got my drone, I've got my 70-200 and my 24-70, so I think I'm good. Got my drink, so all good. Right, good to go. Okie doke. So this is why you need to get out early, because if you look behind me, you know, I'm 48 minutes, so about 50 minutes away from sunrise, and already we've got some stunning clouds, but I'm 20 minutes away from where I need to be, so I need to get going. Stop doing video. Oh, I've run up there quick. Here at the top now. This could go one of two ways. We have got so much cloud coming in, but the cloud is in the direction I'm going to be shooting, and there's still a bit of a silver lining over there. So it could work out. It could be amazing. All right, let's get to the top, nearly there. What a view. The view over there, I'll show you in a minute, is so spectacular. Just need the sun to come out. When I made it to a top, there's sort of multiple tops here. I'll probably sort of go around all the ridges. Just need to make the most of today. All right, time for a drink. Okay, so just whilst I wait for the sun to come up, I've got about 20 minutes. And then plus there's a cloud on the horizon, so maybe it'll give another 15, so probably about 35 minutes. I'm just gonna try and find some sort of wider angle shots and then some long shots as well. I'm gonna use this time as productively as I can. These aren't gonna be the final shots, but these are gonna hone in on the compositions. So what I'm trying to do is use this tree here, which I think is quite nice. And then obviously we've got an amazing background with the Langdale peaks, which are in a lot of my photos. So what I want to do is think, well, where's this tree going to be? So you can see here, I've got the tree sort of lined up with the mountains in the background, but if I move this way, it sort of gives it a little bit more room above it. And it's those little things that can make quite a big difference. You know, if I move this way and go down a bit, to here, say, then you can see the tree sort of breaking the horizon and getting in the way of that snow-capped mountain in the background. So I don't really want to be down here. I want to be just a little bit higher. And doing that, using, you know, your feet with your camera before you get your tripod out, is such a good way of finding a composition. And that's why it's so important to get to a location a little bit earlier. Now, the sun's going to rise sort of over there, and it's going to be almost backlit, which I don't, it's not my favourite type of lighting, but I think for this it'll work quite well, because I think there'll still be shadows cast, and we'll get nice lighting on these trees. So it's just a question now of deciding, do I want this green bit in, maybe, where do I want this mountain to lie, and trying to sort of line that up. I'll probably set my camera up down here, knowing that this is the shot that I'm gonna, you know, this is the good shot. And now, and whilst my tripod set up down here, I'll get my long lens on and try and find some other compositions with that, that are a little bit closer in. Found a shot with a long lens of just these trees through here, and it looks like the rain's coming through in the background. I didn't expect that at all. I thought it was going to be completely clear. There was no rain forecast. I didn't bring a raincoat. So stupid. Why would you ever go out in the Lake District without a raincoat? But anyway, if it rains, I'm going to get really wet. But this composition through here is really nice. I've got my 7200 on. It's around about 150 millimeters. And yeah, I've just got these silver birches through there. I've got a little bit of the rock. I've just picked out some detail and it looks so good. You can see that I've just got, let's move it to this side here. I've just got this rock, in here, and then these silver birch, and then the mountains in the background, which have now almost disappeared. So I need to get a move on, really. Was it a rainbow falling? Okay, it's getting interesting now. I've got some amazing clouds over there that are catching the light, but the sun has just popped up and then gone in some clouds again. I've got to wait at least another 15 minutes for it to come, which by that point, but look at that up there. Oh my God, that looks good. I'm gonna need my wide lens. Right, I'm gonna go down. My camera's set up, as I said, doing it right. So, oh, that light's so good. Look at the light up there now. So, it's just not quite where I want it. Right, I'm gonna have to move this a little bit. I'm gonna put you down on this rock over here. Hopefully you can see me. Okay, right. So, gotta be quick. There's a rainbow up there. Oh, that looks so good. I don't really know what my composition is. Still got a really slow shutter speed, so I've got to be careful. Maybe I just need to go get this rock in here. It might look quite good. No, I don't like that green. Ah! Right, gonna go long and just get the rainbow and just the mountain. Okay, I'm not convinced about this. Oh, look at that rainbow. I don't know what to do. Right, try this. Come on. I just don't like that green. Right, I'm gonna have to go up there. Oh. Okay, this is interesting. I'm gonna go up there now. This is gonna be the craziest vlog ever. Okay. So the light in that direction is so good, but there's no composition. There's no point trying to find something that's just not there. But there's a good composition here, so I'm just gonna try and forget that and concentrate on this, and hopefully the light will come over here. There's a really nice set of trees here and some rocks, which I think will make quite a nice wide angle shot. So, oh, the light over there is so good. Here am I, meant to find little peace of mind. Oh God, I've just run all the way over there. Oh, the light's just incredible. Right, think, Nigel, think. What am I doing? Pano, 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 pano. Right, so I've got it level. I'm going to make sure that my exposure is good across it. It is. Start there. Focus and bracket. There's a rainbow. Oh, yes! Don't get it wrong. Don't mess up. It's raining. Great. That's all I need. It's raining now. Wipe it with my glove. Oh, it doesn't get any better than this. The light is epic. Yes. I'm gonna put the camera down now and take photos because I wanna get some good photos. There's a rainbow, some trees, there's some mountains. This is excellent. What a great way to end autumn in the Lake District. It doesn't get better than this. Yes. And I'm when I reach out, you will hold on. Was it a rainbow falling? Was it a rainbow falling? When I touch you, it will break through. Was it a rainbow falling? Was it a rainbow falling? I've been falling and I've been. You know what? I don't know if I've even got anything. There's literally amazing light everywhere. I've just run around like a headless chicken. Oh, I really hope I've got some. I think the best light's over there. I maybe need to go on top of that hill. I think it's gonna go any minute. It just looks so good everywhere. I don't even know what I'm doing anymore.
Just take a photo, Nigel. Shut up.
Oh, come on. Think. Your hat's not on right. That's the problem. Get your hat on. Right. Okay, hat's on right now. The world's going to be better. Oh, Nigel, what are you doing? Right, I'm gonna go up there. Okay, I've calmed down a bit now and realized that I'm in completely the wrong place, which is usual for when I go fog hunting. So there's fog on Lake Windermere, which is the biggest lake. And not surprising, because it's probably held its temperature, you know, the temperature probably got colder there and, so I probably should be on the mountain just over there, because then I could look into a valley where there's some other lakes. But this is new for me. I've never been here where I can see the mountains. I've been in here in the rain and the fog. So you learn something every time. The views are spectacular, but I'm in the wrong place. So I've got my long lens on, trying to pick out some detail over here. I think there's some. I could just do with a tree just somewhere
on the horizon over here, which there isn't.
I feel like this vlog is how not to do photography. Right, there's a good view over here as well. There's just views everywhere. So if I just sort of... So I'm gonna try shooting over here with my long lens and see if I can get the lake. There's a nice cloud there as well, so I think that'll probably work. So I'm gonna just try and get a nice...
Actually quite nice, that. That's very nice, in fact.
When you're shooting with your long lens, it's a good idea to just think about the clouds, because you just want to make sure that that you don't chop them off. It's a little bit like your trees or your rocks or any other parts of the composition. The clouds are an important part of the composition. And if there's a distinctive cloud and you chop it off or you don't leave enough room above it, then that can impact the composition quite significantly. So just think about that. Try and, you know, compose it in a way that is complementary to the clouds in the image, and you'll find that you'll get a lot more interesting and pleasing shot. So this cloud's moving across now, and I think it's going to work really well over here in this composition. So I think what I'll do is I'll set up my tripod, because I think it's worth getting this right. It's a really nice shot over there. Oh, that was hectic. And I'm not sure whether I got anything, to be honest, but I wanted to say something about that, because obviously I was shooting video and flying a drone as well, but even if I wasn't doing that, it would have still been fairly hectic. You know, I changed my mind on compositions, and you know, I took probably maybe 7 different compositions. But the thing that I think I did much better this time, even though it was quite hectic, is that I gave up on a composition quite quickly. So if I didn't think something was working, so there was one where there was a twisted tree when the sun came on it, and the top of the tree was in light and the rest of it wasn't, I just didn't think that worked. I just moved on from it. Even though it looked good to the eye, it was a good view, it didn't make a good image. And I think this time, you know, in hindsight, looking back, I think that the shot that will look the best is the one before the light hit those trees, and the one to the lake with the long lens. And I spent a lot of time just waiting for that cloud to come over, just fine-tuning that a little bit, just to get it right, because I felt that was a good one. And I think it's fine to move on from a composition, but you shouldn't, because you shouldn't really try and pull something out of a composition that's not going to work. And everybody runs around like a headless chicken when light changes like that, and there's pretty amazing conditions. And especially when you're in a stunning place like this and you want to get, look at it now, it looks good now. But you've just got to go with it. You know, it's very, very rarely that I get somewhere, think, that's the perfect composition, I'm gonna wait there for 3 hours for the perfect light. Sometimes that happens, but it's rare. So, yeah, it was good though. Probably one of the best couple of days photography I've had. Yesterday evening was so amazing. The light was so amazing. The leaves have gone off all the trees up here, so, yeah. It's looking good there. Maybe I'll take another shot. Up the ladder, down the wall. Different mysteries, full of love mixed with tears. We are happy most of the time, and we get along better than fine. Left and right we braid, through the ups and downs we sway. Either way.